the actual climb powers in the thrust limit page, and they'll be revised down, lower, lower again, -5%, -15%. So the initial values of reduced climb power have now matched the maximum climb power. And if I wanted to reduce them now, they would be yet again revised to 1.37. So we'll continue on 1.37. I don't want to climb with max power, it's just not necessary. So we'll just let the nose level. Got 800 to go, 4 altimeters. We'll go ahead and turn on the seatbelts. And because we're now up and high a little bit, I should turn on the traffic. A little look around. Something just below us by 9,000. Everything ahead of us is below us. Something ahead of us just below by 2,000, that's increasing. So we're safe in terms of airspace ahead of us. 18,000, we're going to get the warning now for the pressure, so over the standard, 2992. Our green arc here, of course, telling us where we're going to be geographically when we attain 23,000, but I'll increase the climb now to flight on 2600. As for our route, I would just like to show you on the map display exactly where we're going and how we're getting there. When I go to plan view, I have the step option here. I can still zoom. So we started here, we did our right turn, and we're on our way to Buffalo. FMC recommending, predicting that our top of climb will be just after Buffalo, assuming we maintain a climb up to flight level 350, which is what I selected in the on the page before we took off, on the init ref page. So I'm just going to show you our route by zooming out a little bit. And you see the centre here, that's telling me that the Gedik waypoint is in the centre of the navigation display. Looking away south east. This map is orientated north, and then a right turn of Flamo. Basically a straight line south. We'll start out, this is a step climb, it recommends. This is a bit strange, up to flight 390. We don't have to do that, but it's saying it's possible. So, okay. So a step climb just after Kenepa. Then a good 200, or a good 300 nautical miles until the airport, or more, because we're going to be extending our arrival path to intercept the arrival radio. But I'll talk about that in a lot more detail once we get there. So we're just turning now, we've just reached Buffalo. On our way now to stop. And we'll be level 350 before stop, so that has a 350 in the window. And if I put this now to flight level 350, we can see that we'll be level at about approaching 50 nautical miles. And the top of climb is always revising itself. So I'll set heading indicator to the magenta track, so it's good ambition. I'd like to turn on the anti-ice. I'd just like to show you what happens when I do that. Just watch here. Engine anti-ice now being used. And if I wanted to do wing anti-ice, we have a little green bar here. I'll just pop up the temperature there of the flight deck. Just saw the top of climb just jump down there because it's being constantly revised. nice view of the lake. Goodbye, Toronto. The VNAV speed recommended 322 up to 0.38. Just approaching 0.3838 now. You can also see on the navigation display that the green arc, the top of the climb is now coming to line with the green arc. That's where things will be when we arrive at flight level 350, which is of course our top of the climb. If we have a look at our fuel page, we're currently feeding reserve fuel into the main tanks because we're approaching the last 10,000 pounds of fuel in this tank. Once 40,000 in 2 and 3 works its way down to 30,000, we'll be transferring over to the final phase of fuel management, which means 1, 2, 3 and 4 will be fueling their own tanks, crossfeed valves closed, override pumps 2 and 3, forward and aft will be turned off. We'll have a warning for that in our ICAS window, fuel tank engine. Maybe you've seen that and didn't know what to do. That's what happens. I shall turn off the anti-ice once we've reached our cruise altitude of level 350. The primary flight display you can now see is on the speed. The indicated airspeed is now reducing, or has been reducing for just a few moments, because the VNAV is holding 0.838 Mach rather than an indicated airspeed. Fixed indicated airspeed during climb gives you an increase in Mach. So if we maintain the climb speed of 322, it was technically we'd be at the speed of sound by now, which would not be very good for the aircraft. So fixed climb Mach speed of 0.838, giving us a reduction in indicated airspeed because we're climbing. That will probably level around 290, 287 maybe. We have 1200 to go. See, we're nearing our top of climb. There's no reason why I can't do this. I could just take over with vertical speed, which would disable the VNAV and just allow us to more gently arrive at 35,000. I could set that to maybe 300 feet per minute. It's not necessary, but it could be done. And then once the aircraft has had an altitude capture of 35,000 feet, I could re-enable VNAV to continue on 35,000 feet. Because you can see we're climbing quite steeply. In fact, I am going to do that, just to show you what you can do. I'm going to put that to 500 feet per minute. VNAV is disabled, vertical speed, speed and now manual. That's very kindly put 0.838 for me, because that was the last speed being held, which was the VNAV speed. And top of climb approaching now. There was only 300 to go, so that was very accurate. Page, we're still in climb mode, that will automatically go to cruise. Speed holding well, 0.839. Well, I need to go. And Econ Cruise. So we'll be landing with 65,400 pounds of fuel, which is way above minimums. Altitude capture, optimum 35, max 39. That's altitude capture, back over to VNAV, and that will continue holding flight level 350 without having captured it a little bit too firmly for passengers. You don't need to zoom up to an altitude and then suddenly level out, it's just not necessary. On the FMC, I just wanted to just have a look at the recommended altitudes here. There is a step climb to flight level 390. A common procedure for step climbs is to pop yourself at the optimum, 2,000 feet below the optimum, and then once you're 2,000 feet below the optimum, to climb 4,000 feet. That puts you 2,000 feet above the optimum. That sounds a bit confusing. So at the moment, the optimum is 35,000, which is exactly what I thought it would be. That just comes from experience, I guess. And so what we want to do is imagine that we were actually heavier and we were flying lower. So turn off the anti-ice, just occurred to me. That will block out those green bars on the ECS page I showed you when it was enabled. They'll now be off. I don't want to fiddle with Windows too much. So if we were flying, we would have been flying at flight level 330. The optimum would have increased to 35,000, which means that we would then climb 4,000 feet, putting us 2,000 to the optimum plus 2,000, which would be 37,000. And then we would stay at 37,000, which is 2,000 feet above the optimum, until the optimum reached us again, and it said the optimum was 37. And then it would increase 38, 39, and then we could go from 37 up to 2,000, 38, 39, to be optimum, plus 2,000, 40, 41, which is almost the maximum altitude anyway. So it's quite a nice idea to climb at 4,000 intervals. You can see that the ICAO step size is set here, which is 4,000. But I can change this to anything I want. I can say, just give me step climbs of 2,000 feet. And that will reset the information here and tell me when a suitable moment is, which is 780 nautical miles, to climb another 2,000 feet. If I put 5,000, that says don't bother, because that's 40,000, and that's just too high, it suggests. So let's just say a 1,000 feet step climb would be good in 440 nautical miles, you see. I'll put 3. So we're climbing in about 1,100 nautical miles to 380. So you see that if I had ICAO in here, that would be a 4,000 step climb. And that's what it was. It was 39,000, if you remember. You see? Do you know, I'll be good and I'll keep it with ICAO and we'll do that 4,000 step climb to make it worthwhile up to flight level 390. So we'll stick with the recommendations. And I think that was going to happen just after Kunepa. So on our way to this VOR, which is 270 nautical miles, after this VOR, we'll just pop up to 39,000 feet. We could of course do it a little bit before. We'll see what happens. But otherwise everything's looking good. I don't want to focus anything exciting on the cruise. I'll show you what happens on the fuel management page when the center tanks, so when the tank 2 and 3 match 1 and 4. And I'll come again on the edit when we do our step climb. But I think until then, we'll jump ahead in the video edit to the fuel page. And after that, we'll jump ahead to the step climb. And after that, we'll come back for the descent, because this video was primarily focusing on startup procedures and a few screens, taxi map, and then, of course, landing in Princess Juliana. So, cruising flight of 350.838, as recommended on the FMC, and the step climb is in 1410 nautical miles. Before that, will most likely be our fuel. Switch over. So we should watch main 2 and main 3. Okay, everything looking good. Currently just past 50 nautical miles on our way to Gedik, and the fuel now is 36.5, 37.5. This fuel imbalance can be rectified simply by fiddling with the fuel control switches. So what would we have to do? At the moment we have more fuel on the right than on the left. So we need to stop fuel coming from the left and only from the right. So very simply, I can just turn off the pumps.